Cocaine addiction is something that affects millions of people in America and all over the world. So what our lab is doing is we're trying to see how cocaine addicts, how their brains are altered during addiction, and that which would help us understand how to, in the future, make treatments and therapies for this problem. And so we like to call it studying how the brain encodes drug-seeking behavior, because behavior is such an important part of addiction. So specifically what we do is we measure the neural activities in the brain, and we see how it is changed during cocaine addiction in rats. So we're studying rats, and we also look at it during relapse when there is no drug involved in the paradigm. So far, we've understood that there are specific areas in the brain that are involved in addiction and, you know, facilitating the behavior of drug seeking. And that's a specific part of the brain called the nucleus accumbens. And there are different parts of that brain area which are involved separately in addiction in terms of seeking drug and making the movements to get the drug. In our paradigm, the rats press a lever to get drug. I'm a psychology major. I'm also a neuroscience major, so I was very interested in how the two areas intersect and overlap, and was very interested in science and research to begin with. And Aristide has helped me basically get more involved in that research, you know, go look for an advisor and get started. And also it helps me with my funding for the research, which is very helpful because I can do a lot of other things, such as go to conferences and present my research. That really prepared me for a bigger conference that I went to earlier this year, which was neuroscience in Washington, D.C. And that was in front of the whole field of neuroscience, basically, from people all over the world. And that really prepared me to be able to speak in front of people who are even more advanced in this type of research. My professor is Dr. Mark West. He is very involved in what I'm doing every day. It's very hands-on. You know, I can speak to him all the time about any problems that I'm having in terms of when running experiments and things like that. He's also a physiological psychology professor, so that's really helped his background in how he teaches and things like that. That's really helped me because I was very interested in the subject to begin with. My future plans are to go to medical school. And I'm very interested in the fields of neurology and neurosurgery, and doing this research and being in this lab has really helped me because I've been able to watch surgeries with rat brains, yes, but I've actually been able to watch brain surgery being done, even if it is in an animal model. It's really helped me understand that there are multiple facets of the brain, and that's really, it promotes my interest in neurosurgery and neurology for the future.